Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss clozapine. What is this drug clozapine? Clozapine is one of the antipsychotic indicated for the treatment of schizophrenia. Among the antipsychotics, clozapine is having so many advantages. This drug is an atypical agent, and structurally, clozapine is a dibenzodiazepine. Normally, typical antipsychotics are phenothiazine derivatives, but clozapine is a atypical agent with different chemical structure. It is a dibenzodiazepine derivative. Because of the structural modification, this drug acts as an atypical agent, and clozapine can act on the multiple targets. It can bind to dopamine D1 receptors. It can also bind to D2 receptors and D4 receptors. Apart from the dopamine receptors, clozapine can also block 5-HT2A receptors. By all of these actions, it can produce an efficient antipsychotic action. Apart from this multiple mechanism of action, clozapine is also one of the drugs which is indicated for the treatment of resistant schizophrenia. So this drug can reduce the hospitalization, and it can be used for long term, where the number of attacks can be reduced by use of clozapine. So among the atypical antipsychotics, clozapine can reduce the resistant psychosis. At the same time, this drug causes less extrapyramidal side effects. This EPS is commonly observed with typical antipsychotics, but still atypical antipsychotics can also produce the EPS. Among the extrapyramidal side effects, tardive dyskinesia is one of the important effects which produce some reversible muscle spasm and involuntary movements. But with clozapine, we can observe less pronounced tardive dyskinesia. Therefore, this drug can be used for long term without producing significant extrapyramidal side effects. Another important advantage of clozapine is that this drug can relieve both positive as well as negative symptoms. So negative symptoms such as lack of emotions, blunted affect, social withdrawal, apathy, lack of initiation, these symptoms can be improved with the use of clozapine, because this drug can reduce both positive symptoms as well as negative symptoms of psychosis. So these are the various advantages of clozapine, but still this drug is not widely used because it is having few of the limitations. Even this drug produces less extrapyramidal side effects, still clozapine produces a number of side effects which reduce the patient compliance. And sometimes before the administration of clozapine, few of the tests like full blood count should be done in order to assess ANC, absolute neutrophil count, and WBC count. So blood dyscrasia is one of the important limitation of clozapine, which should be closely monitored on long-term use of this drug. Today in this video, we are going to see what are the important precautions, side effects, how this drug acts, and what is the dosage. All these things we will discuss in this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel and support our work by sharing this video with your friends and click the like button, and your comments are highly welcome. So let us start with the chemical nature of this clozapine. So this is the structure of clozapine, which is a dibenzodiazepine. So we can start the numbering such that nitrogen is getting the least numbers. We can give the numbering like this. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Nitrogens are present at 5th and 11th position, and this is the dibenzodiazepine. Otherwise, it is a benzodiazepine fused with a benzo ring. So we can write this as benzo-benzodiazepine. And it's having saturation at the 11th position, so 11H. Third position, chlorine is there, 3-chloro. 6th position, piperazine ring is attached by 1st position, so 6-piperazine-1-aryl. And to this piperazine ring, at the 4th position, methyl group is present, so 4-methyl. That is the complete name of clozapine. Now let us see the precautions of this drug. Before prescribing the clozapine, blood test should be done in order to assess absolute neutrophil count, ANC, as well as WBC count. These two counts should be done before administration of clozapine, and the normal range of these counts for ANC, they range from 2000 to 6000 cells per microliter, and for WBC It may variable around 4000 to 11000 cells per microliter. So these are the normal values of ANC and WBC in healthy people. So these counts should be checked in the patients before administration of clozapine. But after use of clozapine, the patient may have few of the symptoms such as development of fever, sore throat, unexpected weakness, chills. If these symptoms are observed, then immediately blood test should be done. And sometimes ANC levels may fall less than 500 per microliter and WBC count may fall less than 2000 cells per microliter. In such conditions, immediately the drug should be stopped because this condition indicates the development of agranulocytosis. So clozapine may cause agranulocytosis resulting in neutropenia and leukopenia. In such conditions, this drug should be immediately stopped. Even this drug should be carefully given in the patients with history of agranulocytosis where the ANC levels are less than 500 cells per microliter, or in those patients with leukopenia where ANC is less than 1000 cells per microliter, or granulocytopenia where WBC count is less than 2000 cells per microliter. In all these conditions, clozapine should not be used and it should be immediately stopped in order to prevent further development of agranulocytosis and possible infections in the patients. Similarly, clozapine can produce few of the symptoms such as orthostatic hypotension, bradycardia, syncope. Particularly at very high dose, it can also produce some cardiac arrest. That's why clozapine should be initiated at very low dose and it should be started at 12.5 mg and the dose of the drug should be slowly titrated in order to prevent any sudden damage to the cardiac system. Similarly, this drug can produce some metabolic changes resulting in hyperglycemia, increased glucose levels, and it can also increase the weight gain, and even it can increase the cholesterol levels. Particularly, these metabolic changes are observed after 6 weeks of treatment with clozapine. And with use of clozapine, the patients may develop some chest pain, tachycardia, increased heart rate, palpitations, awareness of heartbeat, dyspnea, difficulty in breathing. If any of these symptoms are observed, then there may be a chance of development of cardiac disorder such as myocarditis or cardiac myopathy. In such conditions, this drug should not be used. And even this drug may increase the QT intervals, which is more important when this drug is co-administered with other drugs, which again increase QT interval. Normally, with the use of clozapine, the QTC interval may be increased greater than 500 milliseconds. In such conditions, this drug should not be used as it leads to fatal cardiac arrhythmias. Similarly, this drug can produce one of the condition neuroleptic malignant syndrome that is commonly observed with many of the antipsychotics. So this drug may precipitate few of the symptoms such as hyperthermia, increased body temperature, muscle rigidity, tachycardia, increased heart rate, and confusion in the patients. Another important precaution is that clozapine can also produce tardive dyskinesia, which is a irreversible muscle spasm. Even it is somewhat less pronounced compared with typical antipsychotics, but still clozapine can induce the tardive dyskinesia. So any development of involuntary movements and muscle spasms should be thoroughly checked with the use of clozapine, particularly on long term. This drug can affect the CNS and it can increase the cerebrovascular diseases, and even it may precipitate stroke and dementia. So in the elders, this drug should be carefully used. Now let's see how this drug acts. On the mesolimbic pathway, dopaminergic neurons are present, and on the postsynaptic neurons, dopamine receptors like D2 are present. On the presynaptic nerve terminals, calcium channels as well as 5-HT2A receptors are present. These 5-HT2A receptors are inhibitory in nature. They decrease the release of dopamine. Now when action potential reaches to the presynaptic nerve terminal, calcium can enter, which results in the release of dopamine, and dopamine can act on D2 receptors, resulting in the activation of postsynaptic receptors, decrease in the cyclic AMP levels. When the cyclic AMP levels are decreased, it results in the development of positive symptoms such as hallucinations, delusions in the patients. Now clozapine can block these 5-HT2A receptors, which reduce the inhibition on dopamine release, but at the same time they can block the D2 receptors. Thereby, they can antagonize the actions of dopamine. So this inhibits the dopaminergic transmission, thereby thereby relieves the positive symptoms. Similarly, in the mesocortical pathway, glutamate plays an important role, and on the postsynaptic neurons, glutamate receptors such as AMPA are expressed. These receptors are coupled with sodium channels. On the presynaptic neurons, calcium channels are present as well as 5-HT2A receptors are present. Again, 5-HT2A receptors are inhibitory in nature. Now, negative symptoms such as social withdrawal and flattening of emotions are mainly observed in the psychosis. Now, clozapine is one of the drugs which can block these 5-HT2A receptors, thereby eliminates the inhibition, resulting in the increased release of glutamate by calcium-mediated exocytosis. When the glutamate acts on AMP receptors, it increases the sodium entry, resulting in activation, thereby it relieves the negative symptoms within the psychosis. In this way, clozapine can reduce both positive as well as negative symptoms of psychosis. Now let us see the side effects of this drug. The important side effects mainly include sedation, dizziness, headache, dry mouth, tremor, and nausea. Similarly, it can produce some tachycardia as well as constipation as other important side effects. How it is given? This drug is available as a tablet. The initial dose of the drug should be started at 2.5 mg given either once daily or twice daily based on the tolerability of the patient. The dose can be slowly increased by 25 to 50 mg per day, such that the target dose of the clozapine is around 300 to 450 mg per day. This dose adjustment should be done by 2 weeks of the treatment, but the maximum dose of this drug is around 900 mg per day. So above 900 mg, this drug should not be given. And along with increasing the dose, the side effects are also increased. So care should be taken to check the development of any side effects with high dose of clozapine. So that's all about this drug clozapine, which is an atypical antipsychotic. This drug is useful in the resistant schizophrenia, but still it can produce few of the side effects such as blood dyscrasias and development of agranulocytosis. So that's all about this drug clozapine. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.